these people with you? They're obviously not simple travelers.
No, my lord. They just arrived, and I thought you would want to see them.
Well done, Thomas. Greetings, friends. My name is Tegan, Ban of Rainsphere, brother to the Arm.
I remember you, Ban Tegan, though the last time we met, I was a lot younger and covered in mud.
Covered in mud? Alistair, it is you, isn't it? You're alive! This is wonderful news!
Still alive, yes. Though not for long, if Tern Loghain has anything to say about it.
Indeed. Loghain would have us believe all Grey Wardens died along with my nephew, amongst other things. So, you are a Grey Warden as well? Is it possible we've met? You seem very familiar. Ah, yes, that's it, exactly. A pleasure to meet you indeed, though I wish it were under better circumstances. You're here to see my brother. Unfortunately, that might be a problem. Eamon is gravely ill. No one has heard from the castle in days. No guards patrol the walls, and no one has responded to my shouts. The attack started a few nights ago. Evil things surged from the castle. We drove them back, but many perished during the assault.
How pointless to help these villagers fight an impossible battle. One would think we had enough to contend with elsewhere.
Thank you. Thank you. This means more to me than you can guess. Thomas, please tell Murdoch what transpired. Then return to your post.
Yes, my lord.
Now then, there is much to do before night falls. I put two men in charge of the defense outside. Murdoch, the village mayor, is outside the chantry. Sir Perth, one of Eamon's knights, is just up the cliff at the windmill, watching the castle. You may discuss with them the preparations for the coming battle. Of course. I have those few who returned from their quest. You know of this, yes? Yes, I question Isolde's decision to send so many knights in search of this relic. But I am a practical man, whereas she is a woman of great faith. Sir Perth was one of the knights sent on this quest. Perhaps you should speak to him if you wish to learn more. Hopefully we can find the source and stop it before it causes any more damage. With luck, we'll also find Eamon and be able to help him. I do not know. They seem to be walking corpses, men with rotting flesh that continue to attack even with the gravest injuries.
Undead? Spirits possessing the dead. There could be several causes behind such a thing, none of them pleasant.
Sir Perth insists. He wants me to be with the villagers, so everyone he needs to protect is in one place. I don't mind, to be honest. The point of all this is to protect the villagers, and I can do that best here. This is the last line of defense, should things go amiss. We could bring some men in to stand beside me, but I'd rather keep the monsters away from the villagers if possible. Very well. Luck be with you, my friend.